We are having problems with a BMW 328i. We have oil spills on the ground, and we were thinking initially that it was an oil filter housing gasket. All that area was covered with oil. After we replaced that, we cleaned the engine, and we find more oil leaks coming from about the same area, but not underneath the oil filter housing. So we started investigating what the problem may be. And under close inspection, there is a missing bolt or missing broken bolt that is underneath the manifold and just behind the oil filter housing. When the engine is going, when the engine is running, you can see a little bit of oil pulling around that one, and behind it there's a big pool of oil. That is how it's supposed to look like with the head in place. This one was missing, so we have to remove the manifold and to fix it. First thing is, can we move it? Can we extract that screw? And we use picks to make sure that we can rotate it some to get the portion of it over the aluminum head, so we can pick it with some other tool to extract it later. We have to remove the manifold. It takes about 3 bolts and 5 nuts, I believe, size 11 millimeters to remove. It's not too difficult. You can remove the airbox and you have some more wiggle room that way. We only need about an inch or two so you can access the broken bolt. So after removing the manifold, moving it a couple of inches out, we use a picker tool to try to grab and rotate that screw. It just takes a little bit of patience, but it's not very difficult. Once you have a good hold on it, start rotating it and extract it out of the head. Should be full of oil, should be well oiled, so rotating it is not difficult. Here is the whole bolt out. And that is the bolt, the new one and the broken one. They're identical. We got that bolt at the BMW dealership. To make sure we can get the proper torque, we have to make sure we have no oil or very little oil in that thread. So first I try with some compressed air to remove the oil. And then we use blue rags from a shop to try to pick up as much oil as we can out of that hole. I think we tried that like 3 or 4 times until very little oil was coming out. Then remove that without breaking it and do it again. We check what the proper torque is, and it's 21 feet-pounds of torque plus 90 degree angles after that. So we set up the torque meter for that, 21 feet-pounds. For installing the new screw, I put a little bit of sealant around it so no more oil can escape through it, and it will try to keep it in place. First we thread it by hand. I use an extension because it is not very accessible, and once we have it covered threaded by hand, we try to use the torque meter to get it to the proper torque. So the proper torque is 21 feet-pound, and then after you hear that click, it's gonna be 90 degrees more. You have to be careful not to break the new bolt that you put it in there. So don't try to over torque it or just give it a little bit more, because that's really not needed. You don't want to break it and try to do it again. After that, we have to replace the manifold. Just slide it into place and put back the 3 bolts and 5 nuts in place. And it's a question of trying to put all the pieces back together. Remember to connect again the airflow sensor and also if you remove the oil temperature sensor and the oil pressure sensor, plug them in again. When you try to torque those nuts, also don't try to overdo it. Just filling them by hand and then filling them snug is good enough. That is the oil pressure sensor put in again and the bolt in place. We start putting all the plastic pieces together again to fill it up and make it run. After that, we have no more oil spills for a couple of days, and we are very happy with it.